In this demonstration of Sertogenbosch, which is a city in the Netherlands, I managed to catch this scene. It was early evening, so the sun was going down over these buildings here, and did make a little sketch, a tonal sketch here. It's a very basic sketch where I wanted my tones. I'll sort of play off some dark so I can pop some figures out in front here. Parasols to the marketeers, the markets will be light value, sky will be light value. But it's very contrajure, the sun's just going down behind these buildings, and I'll show you the photo here. So the sun's just going down, just about there over the tops of those buildings. So I'm gonna allow that to give me ideas in terms of how I want to illuminate my painting. So let's get some paint going here. Man selling his goods, maybe just get him in, and then I think we're ready to go. Please remember to hit the subscribe button. If you want notifications, automatic notifications as and when I upload new videos, then please remember also just to hit that little bell button. And thanks for watching. It's a very neutral colour. There's a bit of ultramarine blue in there, I think, and some probably a little bit of raw sienna. And we can just shape that back there a little bit, perhaps a little bit higher, so we can indicate some interesting shape back there. I think I'm going to put some warm sky in at this point. So I'll use raw sienna for this. Nice summer's evening. And we'll allow that just to make a little contact with the buildings. And as the light does come over that area there, we'll just suggest a little hit of strong light. Let's see if we can get that to party up a bit. So going back to our background colour, more or less, here. Sort of ultramarine blue, a little bit of cerulean blue, a little bit of raw sienna. Need to get a bit more water going, I think, just so we can give ourselves a bit more area to play around, keeping the wet in wet going for a bit longer. Okay, just really mainly sticking to the same first two colours. Get something a little bit warmer over here. That building's quite warm. Let's get a bit of cobalt blue going. Here's the top of our mobile shop. About here. Just cutting around the parasol mostly, not being too careful, but try to avoid it, I think, for now. A little bit of green at the top there, which I shall put in with a little bit of, that's a bit of viridian. Just flitting back and forth, warms and cools really. Good bit of warmth up there on that roof. And that colour definitely seems to sort of appear underneath the parasols. So if we can get something like that under here. So let's try to sort of paint with a no-nonsense direct approach as much as possible. So if you sort of see a dark, then paint it, you know. Try not to let doubt put you off. So it's here. Back around our figures here. As much as I'd like to keep a bit of white around these figures, we've got to be careful that we don't give them a sort of weird outline, a weird halo. Okay, this is okay. I'll just pick up a smaller brush in a moment. I just want to get some of these larger, darker shapes in. Try to keep the movement going as well, that's the other thing. The general pattern. As we move down here, just a little bit darker in some areas. And I will be going darker around this area later because there's a tree here. So just a tad darker again, just to show off those roofs, the roof line back there. Get a little bit of warmth around here before we settle on what we do exactly with the foreground. We'll just get a bit of warmth in there. So we can cool off, you know, sort of going by the rule of thumb that if the light source is warm, I'm getting the sense of warmth from that late sunshine, then the shadows should be cool. Okay, just making sure that I'm happy with these loose shapes. As I say, they've sort of leached into the sky a little bit there, but that's okay, that's fine. This shop front is mostly sort of bluey colour. Just get some hint upon some local blue colour there. Maybe a bit more of that blue there. Okay. So I'm very wary of flat areas at this stage. There's a very flat area of blue here. And I think we'd better try to do something about that just to break it up a little more. Something going in here that we can manipulate. There, perhaps that would be a bit better when it's settled. Really just making sure I'm somewhere near the tone, the correct tonal value. I'm just going to probably adjust that roof line a bit. So we'll go back to something fairly neutral. It's cerulean blue. Not too much water. And let's see, we've got some interesting architectural shape up here. We'll take this chimney out. By that I mean we'll take it out of the scene at the top there. Wherever I can go with minimum amount of fuss, I'll get into this area here. Okay. I'm just getting a slightly bolder brush here. Something that hasn't got such a fine point on it. Again, we'll go back into some of these areas that could be made a little more interesting. The some areas that I'll want to see slightly warmer than others. There's a bit of warmth through here, so I think it's because obviously this light seems to be sort of catching this building at this point here. Okay. And this tree here. Then I'll give a sort of general colour to for the moment. Just making sure I get a nice top on those parasols. Like the way that warmth creeps into that area there, just from the light. Again, we'll go back into here with some darker warms and cools. And I'll let this rest in a moment so that we can put in a hint, start of some sort of sense of detail. So this is ultramarine blue mostly. Little bit of cobalt blue sometimes, and burnt sienna. Just blocking in some abstract here. There's a lot of abstract at ground level. Down to a smaller brush just to manipulate some of that colour a bit more. I think we'll just get a little hint of something warm reflected on some of those interiors on under the parasols. I'll let that do its stuff for a moment. Just making sure now that areas are sort of connected. Take a line out of there maybe. And there are some flags. In and around. So just texturizing areas I know will be a bit busier than others. Some of these areas will be. Yeah, I'm now going to just put a small amount of color on these parasols. It's a sort of, I'm not sure I want them to appear the same colour as what's actually showing in the photograph, because it's a sort of dull pink. But that might do for now. Again, perhaps we'll just put a hint of burnt sienna, raw sienna on those, just to suggest that it's a continuation of the light, the reflected light up there. And then that more terracotta-like colour that these seem to be in my photo, perhaps we can offer that along this edge here. See how that goes. Just lifting a little bit of the pigment off that tree before it gets a chance to dry out completely. There's an area of blue there I'm not too sure about. So just warm that up a little bit, I think. Yeah, I'm just scraping in, lifting out a suggestion of the shapes that are up here. Only a suggestion. Just the odd bit of light that's being caught. Right, I'm going to speed dry this because I'm at a stage, I think, where I have to use a dryer. I have to get things, the surface of the paper, drier for what I need to do next. Okay. Nothing much more I can do here before I dry it. Maybe there is. Maybe a few of those windows can be lifted out. Yeah. And so I still haven't dried it, and I'm just toying with the idea of trying to catch one or two areas that may still be damp, which would be might be better. Just a small brush, size 6, with a good point, and ultramarine blue and burnt sienna is my mix. Okay, let's assume that there'd be a shadow underneath this vehicle. This mobile shop. Yeah, I've sort of put on hold the idea to speed dry it for a moment because some of this is in favourable sort of damp condition to be doing things I won't be able to do later. So make the most of the, you know, of the sort of current condition of the paper. So some details, some rough details back here. Some windows here. So I'm working, if I had to describe this now, I'm working wet into damp. It's definitely, I wouldn't consider this to be wet. It's damp at best. Finding some cooler areas now again. Slightly darker, cooler areas. Okay. And then a few windows over here. Seems to be the edge of a roof about here, front edge of a roof that I can see. Let's suggest some something going on underneath here. So I mentioned earlier there's a lot of vertical. The sense of quite a bit of vertical. There's a couple of characters at the edge of this shape that I've had my eye on, and I think if I can, I'll try to make more of them. Sort of here like this. Those figures that we mentioned further back, getting the scale of these down here is quite important. People a bit closer again. Perhaps we can. Pop those out by the use of a more noticeable colour. And a couple of these figures here. Just making sure that the eye line, eye height is correct. Let's give this figure some paint and then perhaps take some out in a moment. Figures, I always think that if you can play around with colour a little bit in nearer figures and just make the others a little more neutral, a little bit weaker in the background, probably a bit more blue in the mix. Okay. Figure at the market. And then coming back into here again. Just really got to try and indicate what's here without spelling it out. bicycle. Let's see if we can get our bicycle in. Whoops. A lot of warm colour under here. So I'm picking up sort of cadmium orange, cadmium red. Just need a bit of different colour on our figure over there. Awkward bit of white around those two figures. Okay, let's see if we can get some of this inferred detail back down here. Okay, sorry, have I gone a bit quiet on these areas? It's when I'm concentrating, and then a lot of this can be improved upon once I've got a better idea of my washes, etc. So let's have a look at where we can take these closer areas. There's an area here. I keep saying warm shapes, cool shapes, light shapes, dark shapes. Make sure they're all there. And let's see if we can get some connectivity here. So it's not one side, another side. It's all, must make sure it's all cohesive here. So my bicycle might have to go because it's sort of falling in line with an area that needs darkening. Okay, I think it probably is time to get a rigger brush out. Okay, let's get some vertical. There doesn't seem to be a lot of vertical in this painting. Other than a few of these posts and things in here. Now, a little bit of more, slightly more inferred up here of some detail. Okay, I think if I do much more on that for a moment, I'm gonna just lose it. Okay, let's speed dry it. Okay, now I'm just gonna mix up sort of generic shadow colour, which is predominantly blue. So I want it to be a cool shadow. So it's mostly ultramarine in it, a little bit of ceruleum, and probably a little bit of light red. Sorry, not light red, cadmium red. Just taking a quick look at my photo again. I think we shall shadow these. Make some shape around the tree. I suppose the tree has to have a bit of shadow about it, doesn't it? So a slightly weaker shadow down here on this building, I think. Tidy up around here again. And I think I'm going to have to bring some shadow down through somewhere. Just continue where we were for a moment. Yeah, I think the shadow's got to come down through here. So we've got to make something a little more abstract. Okay. As the buildings start turning towards the light a little bit, we'll leave them slightly warmer looking. I'll suggest some longer shadows. Get some nicer colours in here. Now, let's see if we can bring a bit of light back into places. I'm always looking for the abstract in paintings. I just love what the abstract does in these sort of scenes. So I have to think about loosening up again. So, back to a rigger brush for a moment, with some very sticky, almost dry brushed mix. And we'll suggest that because this is in sunlight, or getting hit by the sunshine, probably expect to see a little more evidence of some hard edges. In places. There's a flagpole that we'll move over to there. I think we're more or less there. Just bring a little bit of darkness to that. Just goes off because I suppose it would. It would be in the shadow. Throwing shadow onto here. again. Areas of light need areas of dark. Or areas of strong light need areas of strong dark, more to the point. I think we've got to give this light a bit of colour. So I'm adding a little bit of raw sienna to my white. And these people in this late sunshine. Now getting just a couple of highlights. In one or two places. Should we call it a day there? I think we will. So tried not to think too much about how it was going during the process. I find that a bit fatal. It's a bit of a kiss of death if you start worrying about is it a good painting or a bad painting. Just paint, just keep painting. Worry about the outcome later. Now there was a flag about here. Bit of light over there, a little bit of light here. What was really nice to see when I was there was the acknowledgement to the Welsh soldiers that lost their lives fighting to liberate this town of Stogenbosch in the Second World War, and it was quite moving to be there and see the Welsh flags. Okay, I think we'll call it a day there. Okay, after a couple of hours and a cup of tea later, I decided I wanted to jazz the scene up with a bit of abstract colour. So putting my sort of imagination to test, I thought, what if this late summer evening sunshine was just casting this wonderful glow of warmth across the tops of the parasols and hitting certain surfaces. And this is what I did. So what I'd like you to do is welcome any comments as to whether you preferred this painting before I did this or as it is, as this sort of the rethink version. So your comments be most welcome, and be very interesting to see what you think.